Institute of Physics. So in this video we will talk about charge distribution, particularly surface charge distribution or aerial charge distribution. General information about the course and instructor is given there. So let's proceed. Another type of charge distribution is known as surface charge distribution or aerial charge distribution. It says the charge is distributed on two-dimensional bodies. Then we call it surface or aerial charge distribution. For this type of charge distribution, we define surface charge density or aerial charge density. It is denoted by sigma. In case of uniformly charged distribution, we will find sigma is equal to total charge upon total area. So if the total charge is Q, area is A, so we will divide Q by A, and then we'll find this is going to be the charge density. In general, if charge is non-uniformly distributed, so this will be written as dQ upon dA. Again, to calculate the total charge, if the charge density is known, so we can write dQ is equal to sigma dA. Notations have their own meaning, like this dQ is differential charge. This is a differential charge on differential area dA if the charge density is sigma. Now, in case we need to calculate the total charge, we can go further. We can say the total charge Q is going to be integration dQ. And when we integrate dQ, so this is going to be dQ that has to be substituted by sigma into dA. Now, this will act as a formula for charge calculation in two-dimensional cases. As far as this dA is concerned, for radially symmetrical case, dA can be written as 2 pi r dr. So this 2 pi r dr is for radially symmetrical charge distribution. Using this, we can convert this integration in dual format and we can go for the integration. So let's take an example for that purpose. Let's consider this example number this here. If the charge distribution is, let's say in this case, is uniform and the charge density is known to us, we need to find what the total charge would be. So we can write the total charge is going to be sigma into dA and this integration. Now this will lead to sigma being a constant uniform because of uniform nature is going to be dA. So we can say it's going to be sigma into A. The total charge in the first case is going to be Q is equal to sigma into area. What the area of this uniform disk is going to be? So we know that area is going to be simply pi into r square. So that becomes our answer in case of uniform charge distribution. Similarly, let's say there is another example in which the charge distribution is non-uniform. And that non-uniform charge distribution is given by charge density. Sigma is equal to sigma naught into r. That means when r is zero, that means at the center there is no charge and the maximum charge is on the periphery. So as we move from center to towards periphery, charge density increases. In this case, the total charge calculation will be done in this way. We will start from origin or center point, go up to r distance and consider a thickness of dr that will be annular ring, and we will consider this ring carries charge dq. Then in a two-dimensional case, this dq is written as sigma into dA. Now sigma is given to us as a sigma naught into r. In case of dA, dA is this differential area of this annular loop, and we know this dA is a radial symmetrical case. It could be written as 2 pi r dr using that mathematics. So this small area is this. We can put as here 2 pi r dr. Now to get the total charge Q, we can integrate this dQ. So this integration will lead to 2 pi sigma naught as a constant coming outside, integration r square dr. This integration has to run from 0 to capital R to cover all the charges. Hence our answer will come Q is equal to 2 pi sigma naught r cube divided by 3. So using this integration, we can find the total charge on this non-uniform ring or a disk rather. Thank you.